What's up guys, it's Tommy here and welcome to a brand new Liverpool news video. We will talk about the Norwich-Liverpool game. Fantastic 3-0 win against Norwich City. I watched the game in full and I was very impressed with how sharp and how good Liverpool played. And I was very impressed by the front three. Salah, Mane and Jota started. Firmino came on and as a substitute. Jota scored after Salah dribbles past, tried to dribble past two players. It falls to Jota after great build-up play. And Norwich City, the biggest mistake for them was not getting back and getting into shape defensively, a good shape, after losing the ball, because Liverpool time and again countered fast. And that's what I love about Liverpool, that when we get the ball, we try to get it as soon as possible to the forward players, to Firmino, to Mane, to Salah, to Jota, whoever is open, we try to find them as fast as we can, so the defense doesn't have time to get back and get organized, because it's always a lot harder to break down an organized defense with two banks of four. And I think that Jota's goal was fantastic, even though the Norwich keeper should have done better, Tim Krul, but Jota scored with pretty much his like second or third touch of the game. Jota had pretty few touches in the first half, but he was still very, very influential with his movement. And also, yes, Norwich had a good spell in the start of the game, but they didn't score. In fact, Liverpool restricted them to only one shot on target, which Alisson saved pretty comfortably. And also in the second half, Alisson made quite a few big saves, but they weren't maybe like proper shots. They were like bouncing balls, and Alisson at 3-0, when Liverpool were 3-0 up already, preserved the clean sheet, which was fantastic. And I think when Fabinho and Firmino came on in the second half, Liverpool kicked into another gear. I was very impressed by Firmino. He looked very, very sharp in pre-season, scoring two goals against Osasuna, and he came on for 30 minutes and he scored again, which was a brilliant assist by Mo Salah. Salah was so unselfish, and also Salah is a record breaker. So Firmino tucks it home after Salah finds him after a loose ball from Mane's shot, and Salah squared it to Firmino. He scores the 2-0, and then after that Liverpool looked very comfortable and very assured. I was also impressed with Kostas Tsimikas' performance. Liverpool manager Jurgen Klopp praised him as well. For 80 minutes Tsimikas played absolutely flawlessly, and then for 10 minutes, the last 10 minutes, maybe he lost concentration, maybe he got tired mentally, made a couple of mistakes, and Van Dijk and Milner actually shouted at him to wake up and be more smart on the ball. Tsimikas dilly-dallied on the ball at one point, which when he lost possession on the edge of his own box, which was a little bit dangerous. But I think after Tsimikas played only 6 minutes of Premier League football last season, he just needs time and needs games to get into the rhythm. For 80 minutes he played brilliantly, so I think that's a good first start for Tsimikas in the Premier League. And also the third goal, I mean, how can Norwich set up in a way where Salah, probably the best player in the Premier League, that's debatable, but I think he is, and certainly one of the best goal scorers in the Premier League, is free on the edge of the box to take the ball down, take it onto his left foot, and curl an absolute beauty into the far corner of the net. I just don't understand why Norwich didn't put a player on the edge of the box to just mark Mo Salah, but you know, Salah said thank you very much. He becomes the first player to score in 5 consecutive Premier League opening fixtures, and that is absolutely fabulous. Last season he scored a hat-trick against Leeds United, and previously he scored in opening games against Norwich, West Ham and Aston Villa, and now he scored against Norwich again. So Norwich must absolutely be sick of the sight of Salah and Liverpool, because Liverpool have a terrific record against Norwich in the Premier League. I think we have like 15 wins and 2 draws in 17 games against Norwich, which is absolutely outstanding. And also another interesting statistic, since Jurgen Klopp is the manager at Liverpool, we always scored 3 or more goals on Premier League opening games, which is absolutely incredible, outstanding. We beat Arsenal 4-3, we had a 3-3 draw against, I think, Watford, where they equalized in the last minute. We beat teams 4-1 and also Leeds United 4-3 last season, and now a 3-0 win against Norwich. I think this is our biggest win. Also, we had a 4-0 win, if I remember correctly. So Liverpool are always a very entertaining team to watch anytime, but also on opening day. So overall, I was very, very impressed and very pleased with Liverpool. And imagine that we started with a midfield of Naby Keita, Milner and Oxlade-Chamberlain. So this wasn't even our first choice midfield. That's why maybe the performance wasn't like a 10 out of 10. I would rate it as an 8 out of 10. A very professional, very cultured and very cool performance. But imagine when Fabinho, Henderson and Thiago is back into the team. And also Naby Keita looks very, very sharp, very strong and very agile. And I just pray that Naby Keita stays fit, because if Naby Keita is fit, he is an absolute baller, one of my favorite midfielders at Liverpool. And also I really, really want to see a Naby Keita Thiago link up, because those two bowlers would be absolutely a joy to watch in Liverpool's midfield. And maybe with Fabinho next to them, he could offer the defense a little bit more protection. I'm just so happy that Man City lost to Tottenham. I don't like Tottenham that much, but I dislike Man City even more, especially now that Man City are Liverpool's probably biggest rivals for the title, in my opinion. I will upload my Premier League predictions video probably tomorrow as well. I already recorded it before going on holiday. I just never had time to edit it properly because I want it to be top quality. And I think that Liverpool and Man City will be the two biggest rivals. And find out who I predict to win the Premier League if you want to see that, if you want, in that video. But I think, and I said it in that video as well, Liverpool have to get off to an absolute flying start and get a lead on Manchester City, because when teams are chasing Manchester City, it's almost impossible to catch them, because they can go on a win of 10 or 15 wins in a row at any point, basically, because they have two squads, two teams, two 11s that can finish in the top 4 in the Premier League. Somebody put two different 11s out of Manchester City, two entirely different starting lineups, and both of them looked so strong that they would finish in the top 4 in the Premier League, in my opinion, which just shows that Man City have a bigger and deeper squad than anybody else. And I don't consider Guardiola an absolute genius. Yes, he's a world-class manager, one of the best that football has ever seen, but I still think that Jurgen Klopp is a better manager, because Jurgen Klopp could have done what Guardiola did with Barcelona, with Bayern Munich, with Man City, but Guardiola could never do what Jurgen Klopp did with Borussia Dortmund and Liverpool to win a Bundesliga title, Champions League final with Dortmund, to win a Premier League title and the Champions League with Liverpool. That Guardiola could never do that on a shoestring budget. I mean, Liverpool spent just £35 million in this transfer window and nothing else, and we are still one of the best teams in the country and in the world when all our players are fit. So I think that Liverpool will be one of the major contenders for the Premier League title, and I'm really, really happy that Man City lost, because as I said, Liverpool have a good run of fixtures to open this Premier League campaign. The next 6 or 7 fixtures, I think Chelsea are the biggest or the hardest fixture, and Man City have a lot of big games and a lot of big teams to play. So I consider Man City's fixtures a lot harder, and if Man City get off to a bad start and they lose 2 or 3 games in the opening 7 fixtures, that would be a huge advantage for Liverpool and whoever else gets off to a flying start, because last season Man City only lost 6 games. This season it might have to be 4 or 5 games that you are allowed to lose to win the title, because I think Man City, Liverpool, Man United and Chelsea will be fighting out for the title. All 4 of them look very, very strong. Man City obviously lost Aguero, but they could be signing Harry Kane. I just read recently that Man City are preparing a €150 million offer for Harry Kane. Fabrizio Romano tweeted that out, and if they sign Harry Kane, they will be even more frightening. But I still think even if they sign Harry Kane, Man City are not unbeatable, as Tottenham has showed. If you stay in the game and if you restrict Man City, you can win, because their defense is not the strongest. I still believe, John Stones wasn't playing yesterday, but I think even with John Stones, Man City's defense, if you take the game to them, if you attack them, if you are not afraid, you can beat Man City. And yes, of course, you can beat every big team, but Man City are certainly not unbeatable, as Tottenham showed. And it's just poetic that Tottenham won against Man City without Harry Kane in the squad. Heung-min Son scored a brilliant goal. And Man City started the game very well in the first 15-20 minutes. They looked like a team like champions. After that, Tottenham grew into the game. And in the second half, Tottenham were actually the better team, believe it or not. And Tottenham actually deserved to win the game. And I think Man City have big problems now because of the fixtures. As I said, they have a very, very tough run of fixtures.